हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ विक्रमजीत सिंह। वेलकम टू माय चैनल एजुकेशन जस्ट अहेड। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू हाउ यू कैन इंस्टॉल रेड हैट एंटरप्राइज लिनक्स 5 इन योर कंप्यूटर विद द हेल्प ऑफ VMware। सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट विंडो वेयर यू कैन choose the enter button to install the Linux in GUI mode, in the graphical mode. If you want to install the Linux in text mode, then type Linux text, but right now I'm going to install the Linux in GUI mode and I'm going to hit the enter. Here it is just trying to mount some file system proc /dev/devpts/sys, loading the SCSI driver. SCSI stands for small computer small interface. CD found. To begin the testing the CD media before installation, press OK. Right now there is no need to test the media. I suppose that my media is found and there is no need to test, so that I am going to skip the media testing. Running Anaconda, the Red Hat Enterprise Linux server system installer. Red Hat always use Anaconda as the system installer. This is the welcome screen. Click on the next. Here it is asking for language that we will use during the installation process. I am going to choose the default English language. Click on the next button. Here US English language will be the keyboard language. Click on the next. Installation number. Right now we don't have any installation number, so I'm going to skip installation number. Partitions. This is very useful and very necessary part during the installation. Here it is giving the four option. And I will suggest you always choose to create custom layout to create the partition, which will help you create a partition. Suppose that if you want to install the LVM, then you have to choose the create custom layout. If you will not choose the create custom layout, then you will not able to use the LVM feature. Here you can see that SDA. SDA is the type of the hard disk. I have 20 GB SDA hard disk. Click on the next. I have 20 GB of disk. There are two types of hard disk in Linux, SDA and HDA. If you have drive letter like SDA, then you can suppose, then you can assume that your hard disk is SCSI or the SATA. And if you have HDA, then you can assume that your hard disk is IDE, which stands for integrated drive electronic. I am going to create the partition. First partition will be slash. File system will be extended 3 in Windows. FAT and TFS we use, but in Linux we will use ext3. the size of the partition. This is the main partition. The size of the partition will be 10 GB. Click OK to create the partition. Now we have to create the second partition. Second partition is boot partition. The file system again will be ext3, and partition size is 200 MB. Slash boot is the partition where you keep all the installation files and directories. Click OK to create the partition. And third partition we have to choose, that is a swap partition. Swap space is in Linux is used when the amount of physical RAM is full. Suppose that your RAM is 2 GB and the RAM is about to full, the inactive pages from the RAM will move to swap space, and once your RAM is free again, this inactive pages from the swap will be moved to RAM and will process. Always keep in mind, if you have the RAM of 2 GB, then your swap space will be 4 GB, and if your RAM is more than 2 GB, then swap space will be 5 GB. So right now I have only 1 GB of the RAM, and I am going to create swap space of 2 GB, double of the memory. Click OK. Next, grab Grand Unified Bootloader. This is a bootloader that we will use in Linux to install the Linux. There are two type of grub bootloader. One is grub and second one is lilo, L-I-L-O. Right now we are going to use grub, and click on the next. This is the network part. Here Linux support IP version 4 as well as IP version 6. In IP version 4 you can set the IP manually, and you also can choose the DHCP. Right now we will choose the default option, that is DHCP. Click OK. If you want to assign the host name, then you can choose the manual host name. I'm going to assign it as RHEL5. Click next. Here we have to choose the region. The region will be Asia, Calcutta. Click on next. Root password. In Linux you cannot continue without giving the root password, and make sure you are giving the complex password. Here you can choose the package that you want to install, you can choose the software that you want to install, like in server there are DNS name server, FTP, mail server, MySQL database. There are many more packages that you can install, but right now I'm not going to install any of these packages. I will install the software after the installation, so I'm choosing customize later. Checking dependency in package, select it for installation. Right now it is just going to check the dependency and install the package accordingly. Please watch the full video, and if you like the video, please like and subscribe my channel Education Just Ahead. This is my first video on YouTube, and in next video I will show you how you can install Red Hat Linux 6 or 7 and many more video about Linux. Here choose the next button to begin the installation. Formatting slash file system. Right now it's going to format the file system which we created earlier. This installation will take some time depending on the hardware configuration of your server or your computer. Right now I have only 1 GB of RAM for this computer, so that's why it will take a long time. As you can see at bottom, installation process has been started. Installing glibc common package. And I'm going to push the video to save the time. Performing post install configuration. Our installation is about to finish. Installing bootloader. As I told you earlier, grub is the bootloader. Congratulations, the installation is complete. Our installation process has been completed. Now it is asking to reboot the computer. SDA, assuming drive cache write through. SDA is the hard disk, is this SD hard disk in this computer. Now it is going to start the services. Show details, setting the host name. Here you can see the services which are going to start. Init, entering run level 5, and the status of all these services are okay. Welcome screen of the Linux. Click on the forward. License agreement, we have agreed the license. Yes, I agree to the license agreement. Click on the forward. Firewall should be disabled. We can enable the firewall later. Forward. SE Linux stands for security enhanced Linux. Forward. Kdump used for kernel crash. If your kernel goes crash, then you can recover the kernel from kdump. Click on the forward. Time, I'm going to set my local time. Forward. Setup software updates. Here it is asking to update the software. Right now there is no need to update the software. I'm going to no. I prefer to register at a later time. Forward. No thanks. asking to create a user. Sam is the user that I'm going to create, and password is Red Hat. Sound card is not required. Forward, finish. So finally our Linux has been successfully installed, and I'm going to log in to my Linux. Here we go. Linux has been installed successfully. Host name is Archive5 that we set earlier. Okay friends, thank you for watching my video. Please don't forget to like or subscribe the channel.